Welcome to AG Studio. Today we are going to discuss a program that is a square root of a given number. Let's see how do you debug a square root of a given number. And this is a program to find out the square root of a given number. So let's debug this program and we will see what will be the output. So let me debug and start debugging the program. So I will press on this. So it will start debugging and it will ask some number and I'll give 5 and press enter, and you can see here the square root of a given number 5 is 2.236. if you want we can check it in a calculator, we can open it and you can calculate. That is other thing. So square root of 5 is 2.236, this is output. And now you are going to trace it. And before that, we will see in a calculator whether this value is correct. So I'll press 5 and I'll press the square root, and you can see 2.2360. And I have taken only 3 digits of fraction part. That is why 2.236. So root 5 is 2.236. So let me minimize this. Now we will see this program and let me enable the breakpoints. So debug and enable all the breakpoints. So all the breakpoints has been enabled. So let's start debugging this program. So before going to the program, the most important part in this program is debugging. It will take a lot of time if you are debugging manually. So let me tell, there are two parts in this program. So there are two for loops over here. You can see over here, this is one for loop and this is one more for loop. And this first for loop is for whole part means the whole part, not the fractional part, whole part. And this for loop is for the fractional part. So the logic is very simple. We are going to start with the number one, okay, that is one. So we will find out whether this square root is to finding out the square root by starting from 1. So 1 into 1. So you know how to find out the square root. It is to find out the square root means 1 into 1. So is equal to n. So 1. So next it will increment. Next time the s will be 2. So next time s will be 3. So here you are going to find out the s. S is nothing but your square root. So this is for the whole part. And this one, this part is called your fractional part. Afterwards you are going to add it and you will get square root. Let us debug this program. Okay, you know always the program starts from void main. You know that always program starts from void main. Let me press on continue. So here printf enter the number. So it will ask enter the number. You can see over here the locals over here DSN. So all values are garbage value because it is not yet initialized. So computer will give the garbage values for that before initializing. Afterwards all the values will be put up here. You can see over here when I do the debugging, enter the number. So I'll press continue. So printf enter the number is finished. Now you will ask for the n. Okay, so I'll press continue and you can see over here it will ask for the input. And anyhow, I have given last time it is 5 and now also I'll give as 5. So I'm going to find out the square root of 5. Square root. Okay, so I have pressed enter. Now it's very simple over here. N, you can see the value of n is 5 over here. Now if I give mouse over, 5 is less than 0. Of course it is not. So if it is less than 0 means you can't find out the square root of that. That is why you have put up this condition. Okay, so this one will be true or false. I think you can very easily tell 5 is less than 0. It will be false. It will go to else part. So let me show you. I'll press on continue. You can see it went to else inside that. Now now s will be 1. So you know what is the value of n. You know what is the value of n. So first s will be 1. 1 into 1 is equal to 5. No, s will be incremented over here. S will be incremented. 2 into 2. 2 into 2. So 2 less than or equal to n. So this one will be Yes, 2 into 2 is 4. 4 is less than or equal to 5. No, that is also will not be, that also will be, is not proper. So, yes, will be incremented. So, yes, will be incremented. So, 2 into 2. So, 2 into 2 is less than or equal to n. So, again, so yes will be incremented. So, 3 into 3, it will happen. So, 3 into 3 is less than or equal to, so it will be 3 into 3 is 6. 6 is less than or equal to 5. So false means the for loop will come out, and anyhow you have put semicolon. So a semicolon means it will terminate, for loop will terminate there itself. Okay, so we will see this. I'll press continue. You can see here s is 3. Why s is 3? Because this for loop is worked for 3 times. First s will be 1 into 1, so is 5. So next 2 into 2 is 4. 4 is less than or equal to 5. Next 3 into 3 is, this one will be false. So false, 3 into 3. Now s value will be 3. So s value will be 3. So now you know that s value will be 3. You can see over here. Now that is not the answer. That is not my answer. Let me open the calculator. You can see here. You can see over here. This first for loop is for what part? Whole part. In this whole part is this one. This one is your my whole part. And root 5, 2 is actually answer. But what I got is 3 here. But 3 is not my root. I should get 2 here. That is why I'm doing s minus minus. When I do s minus minus, 3 will be decremented to 2. That is why I will do s minus minus, because every time when you do this calculation, every time s will be, until it will be false, s will be incremented. So s, anyhow you got s as a 3. Now you will decrement it. S will be decremented. When you decrement it, see here, I'll press F5. I am going to minimize this. So when I continue, so you know, you got to know that s is 2. So you know, root of 5, root of 5 is, square root of 5 is, of course it is 2 point odd. Okay, so now you got what part? You got, yes, that is whole part. You got the whole part. Now you should find out the fractional part. So fractional part is over here for d is equal to, why I have given d is equal to 0.01? Because I'm taking, you can take any value here, lowest value, small value. So you can see here 0 point afterwards. I want to increment 2 point. I'm trying to see whether this will hold. So whether this one will be fine, 0.01. I'm going to add 0.01. So s plus s is anyhow 2.001. So every time it will check the condition. Every time it will check the condition, and you can see that every time d will be incremented by 0.01. So anyhow, first time 0.01, next 0.02, 0.03, 0.04, like that until you get 0.236. Until you will get to 0.236. You can see over here now the d value will get changed. I will press on F5. It's you can see the d is incremented to 0.237. So now you can say 2 plus 0.237. So if you do this, so this one will be around, let me show you in the calculator. Let me show in the calculator. So s is anyhow, you know what is a s value, that is 2. 2 plus, I'll do plus. So 2 plus point, s plus d, you can see over here s plus d. So plus d value is 0.237, 0.237. So I'll press equal to, it is 2.237, 2.237. So this one is 2.237 into 2.237. I will do 2.237 into 2.237. This, if you multiply these two, you should get 5. You should get what? 5. But it is more than 5, 5.0416. That is why you are going to decrement, same way what you did here, s minus minus. Here also you are going to decrement d is equal to d minus 0.01. You are going to decrement it by 0.01. I don't want 237, I want 236, nearly 236. We will see what will happen when I decrement d. When I decrement d, I'll press F5. I'll press F5. You can see here the d value was 2.237 minus 0.01, that is 2.236. 0.236. When you multiply 0.236, 2.236, s is how much? S is 2 and d is 0.236. When you multiply, I mean, when you add these two, sorry, when you add these two, you will get the square root of this. We will see now square root, it will have garbage. I will press F5. You can see here 2.236003. This is my answer. This is my answer. The square root of 5 is, you know, square root of 5. Again, I'll show it in the calci over here. 5, this one, square root of 5 is 2.236. 003. It is almost similar. You can see it is, this answer is almost similar. This is the answer. Okay, again I'll press on, you know, you got to know this is the answer, and here also you got yes root is this one. So I'll minimize this. So I'll press continue. Let me show the output screen. See here, the main very important thing here. The square root of given number of 5 is 2.236, but actually I got 2.236003, but here it is displaying 2.236. Why? Because everybody, please watch over here, printf, the square root of a given number, percentage 0.3f, 0.3f means after point only 3 digits should appear. After point 3 digit should appear. See, after point, you can see over here, after point 1 2 3, 1 1 2 3, 3 digits should appear. That is why it is not showing the full answer. It is not showing the full answer, 2.236003. It is not showing, only it is showing 236, because in this I have told 0.3f, that means only 3 digits after fractional part, I mean after point, it will display. So this is regarding square root program. I hope it is very clear of the program is. And once again, let me conclude this program with the two things here. This one is for whole part. You can see this is for whole part calculation. And another for loop is for, this for loop is for fractional part. In the for loop, you are going to start with 1, okay, and 1 every time s will get incremented, next s will be 2, s 3, like that, until this condition is false. This condition is false. Same way for fractional part, it will work. For the same way, the fractional part, it will work. So I am taking d as 0.001. So I am going to add with the whole part s plus d into s plus d, less than or equal to n, n value whatever you give, that is 5. So you will multiply these two and find out the root of this. So every time you are going to add in fractional part, you are going to add 0.01 every time, so that you will get the better result. So this is regarding the square root program. And thank you so much for listening. And this is AJ Studio, and please don't forget to subscribe, like, as well as share. Thank you so much.